Thank you, Elizabeth. So this filter demo by Telecom Italia is focused on machine-to-machine and device management. In particular, we will see how a management authority service provider can remotely manage a smart home with its devices through a universal proposition that is the OMADM machine-to-machine gateway. So here is the target scenario in this case. We have a smart home with many smart devices running, lights, video cameras, temperature control, media servers from consumer electronics. Everything can be connected to a point of presence in the smart home by the service provider. That can be a commercial router. In this case, it's a wireless router that can aggregate the data and the configuration of all those devices and can be connected to a remote server or OMADM compliant. So in this way, the end user will be able to connect, configure, and use his or her own device locally or remotely, but we will be able to provide a way to control and assist the configuration of this local network through a remote infrastructure. And we are leveraging here a powerful OMA specification that is the Gateway Management Office specification that provides a way to remotely manage non-native DM devices connected to a gateway. And then these devices coming from a different field, consumer electronic, building automation, industrial automation, and so on, just need to be physically connected to the gateway through standard interface, for example, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, ZigBee, cable Ethernet, and so on. And then all the data are aggregated into the gateway that is managed by the remote server. So this is the paradigm of the so-called machine-to-machine capillary network. So we have a huge diversity of machine-to-machine devices, but this is not a barrier because through standard activity, we have been able to provide such specifications, so the gateway management object, very flexible, and for any end devices of the machine-to-machine field, you can think to integrate its own data model into a branch of the gateway and then represent the status and the configuration of the end device into the server. So this is basically a way to overcome machine-to-machine devices fragmentation that is for sure a concern. We have to think that machine-to-machine field and sector will always remain a vertical scenario and can be possible to provide an horizontal platform. The answer, and you can see also the demo later on, from our point of view, so working with OMA is no. So we do have a way to overcome such fragmentation. And for sure, one possible management authority from a mobile network operator point of view is the operator itself. So since the DM device management specification by OMA is a very consolidated and worldwide recognized standard, and many operators have invested in such infrastructure. This is also a way not only to overcome fragmentation, but to exploit and leverage an existing infrastructure that initially was devoted only to the feature phones or smartphone case. So, one infrastructure for all mobile devices, also for machine to machine. And this is the case of the demo. We have the router that is an innovative product itself, since it's an LTE router, so it's very flexible. You can install everywhere. LAN side, you have wireless connection. Internet side as well, you have wireless connection. So not only for the home office case, but also for industrial scenarios on, it's a very compelling way to install the gateway. We have implemented the OMADM gateway management object specification directly into the router. This means we do not need any particular appliance, just one box. This is powerful for the home case, for the office case, and so on. Everything runs on the gateway, and the result of the demo we brought here is, and the feedback is also that the OMA specification is really straightforward to implement. So you can bring a live network with a limited effort. So instead of a real smart home, we have such premises. As you can see, it's located in Rome. We couldn't bring here, just the gateway is here. And is in our Telecom Italia headquarter in Rome. It represents one of our retail shop. And of course, there's a lot of devices we can control remotely. From an architectural point of view, this is the scenario. I don't want to stress too many details, but just to highlight the idea that the specification is very flexible. So we have from one side the huge diversity of machine-to-machine device, but this is not a barrier, because the gateway in the center, you can see, can dialogue and talk with the DM server on the left, and on the right, in the demo case, we have performed the integration with the Open WebLAN. It is at the same time an open source and commercial protocol for digital home automation. It is especially well known in Europe. But if we have other device with other functionalities, if we have a similar functionality but implemented with different technology, we simply can define some abstract APIs from gateway to the end devices, representing the data structure of the end devices. And so we just have to change some inner module of the gateway. And this, again, is not a problem, because it is intrinsic in the device management paradigm and protocol that you can remotely install new application and logics module on the product, on the gateway. So you install once, then you can manage all the life cycle of the gateway, and so the life cycle of the machine-to-machine network. Okay, thank you for your attention.